Hey guys, I'm still pretty flashed by Neo Day and this Apple-like presentation and event. And well, today, some Sunday thoughts. This is not your typical type of polished content. I hope you still appreciate it. If you look outside, it's pretty good weather. So I'll quickly head off and have a little bit of a walk. But in between, let's answer some of the more immediate questions and a couple of thoughts about whether or not the Neo Day was successful or not. So first of all, I would like to stop comparing Neo to Tesla. I see lots of talk around this in the forums, a couple of commenters and so on. And if you still try and compare Neo Day to what Tesla is doing, then you still haven't understood Neo, period. I mean, if there's something that Neo Day has shown yesterday, it is that they are not going after Tesla. They introduced the new ET7, which is a sedan that is comparing to the German brand OEM style premium to luxury sedans out there. So it's direct competition to the BMW series and so on. Also look at the official teaser where the Neo ET7 is overtaken an Audi car. So this is not a coincidence, guys. If they wanted to, they would have put a Tesla in the video. And we did not hear anything about expansion of factories, lower priced models and so on, which would be the way that Tesla is going if you wanna invest in the cost leader, in the company that is the quickest to scale and to, you know, go global and something like that. This is Tesla and has nothing to do with how NIO is positioning in the market. But now let's talk about, you know, the events that have been rumored before, like ET7, a new battery swap station, the 150 kilowatt hour battery and so on, and what they ultimately shown and how this compares to my previous assumptions. So first, as these are just some Sunday thoughts, I'm not going too much into detail of the technicals and so on. I will do much more refined analysis later on. So make sure to hit the like button, subscribe to the channel so you get a notification whenever I post a new video. This is important because the YouTube algorithm will most likely not show you my video in the main feed. So make sure to do that. I'm not going too much into the autonomous technology that they've shown. I think it's great that they have shown their platform and the way that they wanna introduce autonomous technology. Whether or not this compares to Tesla in a way that they have, you know, more computing power or not, I think it's quite irrelevant at this point in time. It just shows the unique way how NIO is going to tackle that, and you can clearly see that they are going with a unique Chinese approach here, thereby implementing LiDAR, V2X technology and new sensors and so on, which give them more security. And I think that is also ultimately what makes the differentiation between Tesla and Chinese OEM, is that the Chinese, as I've gotten to know them, are pretty much uncertainty avoidant. Security is a high issue. So the Tesla approach is much more, let's say, ambitious, adventurous and so on. Whereas Chinese users, they really prefer lots of security measures, fallback solutions and stuff like that. So you see lots of redundancy, computing power, better measurement and so on with the NIO introduced solution here. That doesn't mean that NIO is going to go the Tesla approach where they have a fleet awakening of robotaxis that is global, right? NIO just has the ultimate goal of having the better user experience in the end, and are striving to give the best user experience possible in China first. And this may be the high quality approach that they're going here, thereby introducing LiDAR and so on. And that was actually quite clear if you have watched like how they invest with NIO Capital. And if you've been following NIO for quite some while, like I have, then also the rumors about Nvidia, well, that wasn't surprising, as well as now the news around the 150 kilowatt hour battery, which is the next topic that I want to talk about, isn't that surprising at all as well, in terms of that they are using this new solid state technology, which, well, still, it was mind-boggling to see that they now come out and talk about it. But I mean, there have been the rumors before, and I'm referring to this article here that's dating back to 2019 that Prologium is partnering with NIO to develop solid state batteries. So the only difference now is that they're now going out and say, look guys, we're gonna bring this to market and in the foreseeable future, and this is the way that we are improving the capacity of our battery packs and also the range of the vehicles. So if you look at this article here, you can see that it's pretty likely that this is the solution that is going to be implemented with NIO. Also, I think even the battery pack looks similar to what NIO has in place. And also the timeline here seems to be quite similar to what NIO has proposed during NIO Day. And regarding the battery technology, I think the interesting fact here is that they are going with the so-called MAB, multi-axis bipolar technique. I think that is the way to find a balance between the expensive and hard to introduce solid state technology with existing technology, and thereby still keeping kind of the cost in a balance if we follow this article. But as I've mentioned, this is just a quick thought here, an update on a video. I'm not going too much into detail. We'll do that later with maybe a separate video just on this battery. But I think the main goal here, or the main outcome here of NIO Day, is actually that they, you know, set this benchmark. Now they say we're gonna introduce this kind of range in the future and this technology. And the important news for NIO is just that every car in the fleet will be able to upgrade to this in the future. So this is the key value proposition of the battery swapping technology. So a user that is actually buying a NIO car today, they most likely know, well, in a couple of months down the line, whether or not this takes a little bit longer, I still have the option to upgrade to this new technology. Whether or not I need the 1000 kilometers of range, that's still another question. It doesn't really matter in my point of view so much, because there is just this option. And we know these are some of the biggest barriers to adoption of electric vehicles, the range, anxiety, and so on. Everyone who's driven a Tesla or electric car, this actually in normal days, that doesn't play that much of a role, but still in the purchase decision, that is a big argument usually. So with that brings me to the new battery swap station, on which, apologies, I've been wrong with my assumptions. I was thinking they would introduce a new swap station that is able to do around 190 swaps per day. Turns out it can do more than 300. That might be just once again an optimum case there, but with a higher capability of storing packs. But here once again, ultimately this shows that with the improvement in the battery swapping technology, this will be a major game changer in terms of the user experience, and also in a way of adopting this technology, not for everyday charging, but for the use cases where you want to have the swapping. And it's given a way of adding a better user experience. Once again, this is NIO's key core KPI. That's what they're working on. And on top of that, with all of the benefits around upgradability, the ability to have a quicker a change and charge of the car and so on. And this is just amazing to see that they have those efficiency gains. Biggest problem I had is that they didn't announce the cost for such a swap station, so that leaves me in the dark regarding my business case and so on. But anyways, I'm gonna use that and now implement all of those new findings from NIO Day in the revaluation of the company. What else? Well, I think the fact that they are going into this emission trading scheme, also with partnering with the trading exchanges of those certificates, I think that could be really interesting and good news regarding incentivizing users to actually save those carbon emissions. I've been previously working in the German Chamber of Commerce on actually such projects, so I know that this is a cool way of actually putting some economic incentive on actually improving the environment. So it's cool to see that this is part of the mission of NIO, and in correlation with the NIO coins that they have in the app and so on, and now building up this ecosystem, that could be a cool new business model, to be honest here. And I'm quite excited to see this also in context, in the bigger context, on what's currently happening with, in the crypto scene and with cryptocurrencies and stuff like that. That may turn out to be a bigger business in the end that we would now assume currently after the business model, after the NIO Day. And yeah, this comes also aligned with the new fashion line that they have been introduced. I mentioned it a couple of times that I'm very bullish about the prospects of NIO e-commerce. I think they may have more than 100 million users on their app in the foreseeable futures, despite how many cars they're gonna sell. And that turns into another e-commerce business, and those fashion lines and the partnerings with other brands and so on. I think in the future will be a large asset if you think about brands that wanna sell to these high net worth individuals in China, because that's basically where we've seen NIO is positioning themselves with the pricing of the ET7 and how premium and luxury it is aligned with their mission. So it's really cool to see that. Makes a very sound impression to me, and I'm really happy about that. So my general takeaway would be that, well, I think you can see it, I'm still kind of stunned and taken away by what I've seen and witnessed. It was exciting to see. Sometimes I was kind of speechless about what they've shown, although it was quite close to what we have been rumored. But I'm still impressed by, you know, this Apple design like car, which really looks very sleek. But now let's take it for what it is. It was a marketing presentation and with some timelines that are in the future. So now they need to show that they can execute on it. And I believe NIO has shown in the recent past that they are able to execute on their plans. And that's the important thing. So from a shareholder perspective, I think what NIO Day has done is taken out some risk in terms of you know, the valuation of the company, because there are now so many business opportunities ahead of that. They have shown how they are going to approach autonomy. They have shown how they going to position in this premium market, in this lucrative premium market. They have shown how battery swapping and the new battery technologies will be introduced in the system. And all of that makes NIO a much more safer investment in my views. Whether or not this should cause NIO to, you know, go to the roof, I don't know. And I think we shouldn't be you know, too keen that this is happening, you know, all of the next day. I mean, NIO for me is a long-term 5 to 10 years out investment, so it doesn't have to happen all at once. Maybe investors can be a bit patient and wait until they actually, you know, bring this stuff to the market, because that was also my takeaway. I want to see the autonomous cars on the road and see how good they are and compared to, you know, what else is on the market. I want to see how the 150 kilowatt hours is actually a battery is actually going to introduce and such things like that. That's what it is. Tesla presentations are no way different. Apple presentations are no way different. They promise some stuff, and in the end, they need to execute on that. So now we know the roadmap, and hopefully see much more details in the coming days and weeks. I will definitely make sure to cover it here on the channel. So stay tuned for that. Please like and subscribe and share. And yeah, thanks you guys for watching, and enjoy your Sunday. By the way, interesting to see the NVIDIA chipset called Atom, and NIO's autonomy vehicle projects are under the codename Eve. So, well, these are the Sunday thoughts for now. Enjoy it and see you in the next one.